name is Kristin Russo.
My name is Dannielle Owens-Reid, and we run an organization called Everyone is Gay.
And Everyone is Gay, so we started Everyone is Gay as a website where we gave advice to LGBTQ youth. Age 13 to 24 is our demographic, but then it expanded. So we now give advice. We make videos, which are also advice-based. We travel to schools across the US, high schools and college campuses, and we just started working with parents whose kids have just come out to them. When we started the site, we had no concept of what it was going to become. I mean, our first question on the site was like, how do I know if my dog is gay? You know, we were trying to be funny and make jokes and be, you know, kind of sassy, which is where Everyone is Gay originally came from, that name. But then as we saw, you know, tons, thousands upon thousands upon thousands of people submitted questions that were not funny in nature. And when we decided to try to tackle those, we looked at the name Everyone is Gay again and sort of reassessed it. And what we realized was that so many of the questions we had were, you know, I want my parents to approve of me and I'm afraid to come out to them. I want my friends to understand me. I came out to them, they're being supportive, but they don't get it. And so what we started to realize was that if you say, let's say everyone is gay, let's say everyone is trans, let's say everyone is bi, take that out of the question and you're asking really ultimately, do my parents approve of me? That's something I want. Do my friends understand me? That's something that I want. And so that's what the name means to us now.
Right.
But we didn't start.
We only exist on the internet, basically. We started just as a Tumblr and eventually started doing YouTube videos. And now we do go to schools and we're writing a book, but all of that came through the internet. They can read our advice. They can watch our videos, which include lip syncing. They can ask questions totally anonymously and not have to put a name behind it and ask anything they want.
Tumblr is kind of like the launch pad for a lot of other projects that we work on. I think the shareability and like the community of Tumblr is what drew us to it from the get-go. You know, you tag something LGBTQ and people search that tag and they find you and they're like, oh, everyone is gay, cool, I'm gonna follow that. And then we're just always a presence, you know? I don't think people read our advice every single day, but it's the kind of thing where they can if they want to and if it applies to them, and otherwise it's not taking up a bunch of room, they just scroll through on their dashboard and that's
And having the feed on Tumblr is really important because it's not like people are physically going to our website every day because they want to read advice. It's like they trust us, they know us, and if they see something of ours on their dashboard, they're like, oh, cool, yeah, I know these girls, I'll read it, as opposed to having to remember to go to it every day.
Right.
To be able to type in coming out or parents or I don't know what other things there are. That's it.
Just coming out parents.
To be able to type that in and see like 12 questions that we've answered about coming out is so important, especially to the youth who come to our site.
Yeah, and we've used that tag feature for other things as well. You know, you can we've had like a tag for specific posts, and then when we tag that thing, we can give people a link and say, like, here's all of our posts on this particular subject. So it's important for finding us, but tags are also, I think, important because you can use them in other ways.
Yeah, and even on a like boring back-end side of things, when we were trying to build Tumblr into a website, which is a cool thing that Tumblr allows you to do with adding pages, you could have like a video page and it would just be like your Tumblr hashtag videos or whatever, and then all of your videos, you know, so it was just easier for building a site and also for connecting with people.
Mm-hmm. And people love hashtags.
Right.
It's the world's favorite thing.
We do get feedback about our Tumblr on other forms of social media. Like, we'll get emails, or we'll get tweets, or we'll get, you know, things like that. But I feel like people use our ask for asking questions.
Yeah, most people use the ask for questions specifically. But when, I mean, I think that a common thing on the internet in general is that people are much more vocal about what they disagree with than what they agree with.
True.
And we have had, like, when we've posted things that people have been not happy about, they are very vocal via Tumblr, both on the ask and now Tumblr has the reply feature, so you know we see the reply feature as well. You know, yesterday we answered a post about two girls who were so in love that they just couldn't get out of bed and they needed help on figuring out how to get out of bed. And so many people had things to say about that. They really were like, did my girlfriend submit this?
My girlfriend must have submitted it. Was this you, Muriel?
So it is. It's fun. I mean, it's a fun community. There's a lot of dialogue that happens back and forth. I think our biggest thing to this, like from day one, has been humor. I really, really do. I think that there are funny Tumblrs, and I think that there are Tumblrs that offer helpful advice, but I think very, very few deal with things in a way that is accessible through humor. And so I think that that content-wise is what has set us apart and what continues to set us apart.
Especially when you think about people who stumble upon our Tumblr and don't see it through whatever they literally Google, I'm gay, what do I do? And they find our Tumblr, and to be so afraid and to not really know what you're feeling and to be confused, and then to be able to read about it and laugh about it and realize that it's just one tiny part of life as a whole, I think is so helpful and just makes people feel like they're real people and they're not going through this humongous thing that nobody else has ever gone through.
You know, Dannielle and I answer a lot of advice, and we have a panel of other people who answer for us so we get other perspectives, but there's a Tumblr called The Art of Transliness, which is two trans guys who run the blog, and they answer tons of questions for the trans community, and I love it. I think their answers are like super succinct and very clear, and they also use like links on the side so that you can search specific things and find articles. So they're one of my favorite Tumblrs in a more serious nature, advice-based nature, I guess you could say.
On the funny side of things, we have a friend named Kristin, Kristin Tuna, who everything that she posts on Tumblr is hysterical, to the point where I will reblog like five of her things in a row, and then I will literally just have to be like, can you just run my Tumblr? Because I don't even know what I'm doing anymore.
Yeah.
Like, I just, most of my Tumblr is her Tumblr.
It's a beautifully curated
it's
Tumblr.
It's really beautiful.
It's just
curated.
Perfect. It's perfect. I'm like, oh man, I was talking to Dannielle about it the other day because I was like, our Tumblrs aren't as good, our personal Tumblrs,
yeah,
because we have like a mix of what we use our Tumblr for. We
right.
We both post things that we like the aesthetic of or whatever, but we also like reblog advice posts, so it's not like just this like beautifully
right.
curated space.
Well, and I think that I feel like hers is specifically just hysterical things, and ours is like our personal life, kind of funny things, like pretty house stuff, and then like advice and parent stuff, and hers is just like hysterical, 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 hysterical.
Cute. Another thing that I think has made us successful in our Tumblr is that it's consistent. We post once a day,
right.
every day except for Saturday and Sunday, and I think that is very, very likable for people. I don't think that people like to have like no posts and then 40 posts and all of a sudden
right.
you're just reading like, oh, everyone is gay all the time.
Yeah.
And I think that regularity and knowing what to expect has really helped mm-hmm. people gravitate towards our work as well. I think if a Tumblr is specific to one particular thing, it does better because you know exactly what you're signing up for.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I think that when you know that, you're just like, I'm coming to Everyone is Gay. I want advice and I want to laugh sometimes.
Yeah.
Whereas like my Tumblr, you know, my personal Tumblr, people follow it because they know me from Everyone is Gay.
Right.
And it's interesting, but I don't think that it has the same draw because you literally don't know what you're going to get on my Tumblr.
Yeah, I guess I agree with you, and I feel that people connect with human beings. So they follow you and they don't really care what they're going to get. Like, they are just excited that you have a personal Tumblr and they get like a little peek into the things that you like and the things
true.
That you think are funny.
So what we're saying is I'm very interesting.
Yes.
I feel like rebloggability
yeah.
is key. We've learned a lot, I think, over the last 4 years with our Tumblr. When we add too many things to one post,
mm-hmm.
it is not reblogged as often. You know, if we're like, hey, you guys, we have this sale, and also here's this other thing and this third thing, then you really, it like waters down the post and
right.
it becomes less rebloggable. Whereas when we're like, here's a picture of us doing something silly, it gets all the reblogs, you
right.
know? So I think being very direct about what you're posting in that individual post is key.
And I think that like the headline of your post slash the shareability of it without having any idea what the content is very important. And I think that's why lists, even though lists, I feel like people are sort of like, okay, I've seen all the lists now. That's why they're so easy, because you see a list that's like 15 things you only know if you're from Long Island, and
every person from Long Island
is like, yeah, me, yeah. I know them, and hasn't even read them yet. And I think that that's really important. Even like we posted our breakup playlist the other day. I really think a lot of people reblogged it just knowing it was a breakup playlist.
Right, before they even
like,
read the song.
If people don't have to read, they're super stoked on it, and they will be sharing it.